وأثبتوا لله أن أصنف الله سبحانه وتعالى أيت صفات أمي فما تريدية أثبتوا لله تبارك وتعالى أي أصنف الله سبحانه وتعالى أيت صفات فقط أمي and they differ with the Ashaira and only one. It is al-hayatu wal-qudratu wal-ilmu wal-iradatu wal-samu wal-basaru wal-kalam. What takween? Is the one in which they differ with the Ashaira. So they affirm for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the sifat, life, qudra, power or ability, knowledge, الإرادة will, السمع hearing, البصر sight, الكلام speech, and التكوين creating or bringing into the kawn, bringing into existence. These sifat, يعني as we know, the أشاعرة مداروا على العقل. The basis for the affirmation of these seven sifat is that the aql yani directs towards affirming it. The aql directs towards affirming these yani seven sifat with the Ashaira, but these eight with the Maturidiyya. And all the other sifat they negate. All other sifat. Besides this, yanfawna jami'a sifat. Ma qala hadhihi thamaniya. Negate all the attributes of Allah except these eight attributes and they reinterpret all the text of the sifat yani with regards to other than these eight attributes. Then how do they affirm these eight attributes? This is another problem. So they're affirming eight attributes, how do they affirm it? Right. When we say as-sam', Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is hearing. What does Ahlul Sunnah say? Allah hears everything. Allah hears everything. Every voice, every sound, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He hears it. Whether you whisper, whether you, doesn't matter. Allah hears everything. To them, it is idraakuhu. It is idraakuhu bil aswaat. It is his perception or knowledge of the sounds or what is audible. So it doesn't really hear. Doesn't really hear. It is idraq. It is knowledge of what is heard. It is knowledge of what is audible. And when they affirm his basar, his sight, Ahlul Sunnah says Allah sees everything. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Aqidatul Salaf al-Salih, Allah Ta'ala sees everything. To them, sight is idraakuhu bil mar'iyat. Is it his perception of what he sees? Yani his knowledge, his idraak, his encompassment of all that which he sees, and not that he sees. Subhanallah, this is, you know, they're playing with words. I'm saying one thing, and I explain it to be something else. I say I affirm Allah's hearing, but when I describe Allah's hearing, it's not hearing at all. Kalam, they affirm for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala speech. They affirm for Allah al-kalam. But then what do they say? What is kalam? Al-kalam al-nafsi. Al-kalam al-nafsi, al-qa'imu bi-dhatihi. It is inner speech, which exists within the dhat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His inner speech, which exists within the dhat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la yasma'uhu al-ibad. The slaves do not hear it. The slaves do not hear it. The slaves of Allah do not hear it. It is not audible. So, how does our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a person, nada Jibreel, he calls Jibreel. But he's not going to hear. Huh? SubhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah ta'ala, when he loves a person, nada Jibreel. He calls Jibreel and he says, Ya Jibreel. He says, Oh Jibreel, inna Allah habba fulan. Verily Allah loves so and so. So love him. So love him. فأحبه جبريل and Jibreel loves him. فنادى في أهل السماء and Jibreel, he calls the inhabitants of the سماء يا أهل السماء, Allah Ta'ala loves so and so, so you all love him. And so they all love him. And subhanallah. How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to us? You know that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, as Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he sends to the سماء الدنيا. When the last third of the night remains, and Allah Ta'ala says, is there anyone who wants to ask so that I may give him? Anyone who wants to make istighfar so I may forgive him? Anyone who wants to make tawbah so I may accept this? Is tawbah. They say, no. Kalam nafsi. Speech is within Allah. Speech is within Allah, and it is yani qadima, no. It is eternal, it is ancient, it is not yani Allah speaks to whom when he wants. No, it's a sifa which exists within Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and that which is transmitted, here comes a bit of an issue, that which is transmitted, Abu Mansur said it is a hikaya an kalamillah. It is a narrative of the speech which is within Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not that Allah spoke. So Allah didn't speak to Jibreel. Allah ta'ala didn't speak to the malaika. Allah ta'ala doesn't speak to the anbiya and the rusul. Rather, it is a narrative that is narrated and related. Abu Hassan differed. Abu Hassan said, no, it is a ibarah. He didn't want to use the word hikaya. Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, he changed from the word hikaya. He said, no, he prefers the word ibarah. It is an expression rather than a narrative. You know, rather than a narrative, it is an expression of the meaning which is qa'im li dhatillah, that exists within Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahlul Sunnah, they say, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. Allah spoke to Musa, speaking to him. Subhanallah. Allah spoke to Nabi Ibrahim. Allah spoke to our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah mentioned this as a fadl of some of the anbiya in the rusul that they were chosen with. Allah gave them a higher virtue. Through what? Through speaking to them. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهُ وَرَفَعَ بَعْضَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٍ. تِلْكَ رُسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. Those messengers, we gave preference and virtue to some over others. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهُ. From them are those who Allah spoke to. وَرَفَعَ بَعْضَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٍ. And others, He raised in their درجات. If Allah doesn't speak, then what is the meaning of this ayah? How does Allah raise them with His speech when He didn't speak? And He doesn't speak. And why do they negate the speech? Because they say, if you say Allah speaks, it means... No, this is kalam. This is kalam. If you say Allah speaks, it means that Allah needs lips and a mouth and... What do you call this?
Vocal cords.
Vocal cords. So what... Subhanallah. They are more closer to tashbih than those who they are blaming for tashbih. When they say these things, it's because they are likening Allah to the creation and then they negate it. Whereas Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say, we affirm it as befits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? Only Allah knows. How it is, its modality, its detail, is only known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't know the kayfiyah. Just like we don't know the kayfiyah of His dat, we don't know the kayfiyah of His sifat. Just simple as that. Problem is that people speak about things that they don't know. And this we know. For the fact that, you know, the aqidah of Abu Mansur al-Maturidi is not taught in the madaris in detail. The Aqidah of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari is not taught in these madaris in detail. But now you come and you speak about it without knowing it. Without knowing it. So this is dhulm. And then you ascribe it to Ahlul Sunnah. You ascribe it to the Salaf al-Salih. You know, whereas the Salaf al-Salih was in a completely different path than this.